Hey guys, okay, so what we're gonna do is we're creating our portfolios, right? So I'm gonna start over. All right, here we go. Here, let me take off my mask so you can see me. Hi, nobody's in here anymore. That's just me. So what we're gonna do is create a hi, we're gonna create a new document. Photo document that's 4 by 6. See that? You just type in 4 by 6, make sure it's inches, 300 resolution, and then you're going to open up your images. I have mine in my downloads. Here we go. Just double check your image size, go to image size, make sure they're 300 resolution, and then you can just bring it down to like 4 by 6, so it's not so giant. And then you select it and you go edit copy. Go over here, edit paste, and then go edit free transform and just scale down your image. So you want like it to fit 3 across and 3 down. Okay, so kind of up to you how big you want those to be. And it's helpful. Let me fix this. It's helpful, if you duplicate the layers more over here in your layers to kind of see if you want to just like use this as your little guide here. So one, and then you have one more here. Duplicate it, and you can kind of see like how far up you need them to be, kind of to see like where to place everything. It's helpful. And then you can copy like that exact size, right? When you're doing it. It's also helpful if you want to pull up your guides, you go view rulers. See here, the rulers is checked. Now it's not. Rulers, view rulers right here. And then if I pull the guide straight down there, then I know I can kind of set my pictures here where I need to set them, right? So I set the next row down there. So let me open up another image. File open. Here we go. Image size. I want this one to be 4 by 6. We actually want them to be smaller than that, but I'm just started going there. Edit paste, edit free transform. And then we just kind of match it up with the other one. There we go. Put that in the middle. All right. So, and then for those of you who have s pictures that are like one's horizontal, one's like I want to use this picture, but I'm going to use it as a vertical. So I'm going to go to crop and I'm going to crop it at 4 by 6. And so it'll look like the other pictures. So I'll just crop it like that. Go again and check the size. Make sure it's right. 300. And we'll do 4 by 6 again. I use this marquee tool. It's the second tool from the top. Edit copy. Go back over here. Edit paste. Edit free transform. Get the corner. Wait, what just happened? Okay, hold on. All right, go back to this. Edit free transform. Get the corner. All right, line it up to a picture to make sure it's the right size. I'm going to put this one down here because my watermark's going to be white. Also over here in my layers, I'm going to put a rectangle. I don't want it to be a white background. For me, I'd prefer it to be a rectangle that's like either black or a color that's in my, so I bring this down. I use my color picker and double click the color in there. And so like I could use any picture color that's in one of my images. See that? And then it'll look good. So look at, there's the pink, here's the blue. All these colors are coming straight from the picture. So it's cool. I don't know. I kind of like black though. So I'm gonna use black. And then remember when we did our watermarks, we put them as a brush. That way we could just, if we do a new layer, I can just stamp my watermark on there. I mean my, yeah. Put up at the top, and then you go edit free transform, and I can make it bigger. So that looks really good. I'll just put that straight in the middle. And I like to duplicate the layer so it's nice and bright. Now, if you have to make another one because something happened to yours, you can. You're just going to use the text tool, draw it really big, backspace it, write your name, and then do like a script, some type of a script where it looks fancy. I don't really like that one. But remember, you can download any fonts you want, or if you're using Adobe from the cloud, you can just turn one of those on. Ooh, this one's fancy. So look, then I just go over here and right click and turn it into a shape. So now when I go edit free transform, I can scale it nice and big. See, that looks cool. And then on another layer, I would do photography. So you have to kind of click off of it. On another layer, I do text photography, but I do it in a font that's easy to read. And I'm gonna do it in all caps. Okay, so watch. See, obviously that's not good because you can't read it well. So I'm gonna put like Arial or something that you can read photography, and also I'll make sure I spell it right. Photography, capitals. And then always go back over here to layer and make sure it goes from a text to a convert to shape. So I can then edit, free transform it, and I can like size it however I want. So I'll put it behind this a little bit, Command T. I'll just put it a little bit behind, push return and put it underneath the other one. Something like that. I don't know. Obviously, I like my other one better. I'm going to put that one back up. Where did I got rid of it. So I'm going to go ahead and do my original one, which I spent lots of time with that. I prefer that. So I do a new layer, stamp it on there, Command T, make it nice and big. This was my one that I worked hard on and I really like. That looks more like how I want my brand to be, right? And then once I've got nine across. So like here, let me just give you an example. I'll duplicate another layer so you can see what that would look like. Nine across, right? 1, 2, 3. And actually looks like I'm a little too far over on this side. So I'd actually have to come back and kind of change that up a little bit because my, this one was too much over on the edge. So that's why it's good to kind of figure it out where everything's going to go first so you don't have to keep kind of messing with it once you put them down, right? So all these should be lined up. These bottom ones should be lined up. And it's helpful to have these kind of the ruler and then just use your arrows. Make sure you're on the right layer. So I'm looking for the bottom one that's white now. Where I can't find it. Oh, here it is. Just make sure it's pushed over. And I think, can't really see. I have to turn this off to see. There we go, to see kind of where I have it lined up. And this one's lining up better there, or, you know, you just have to decide how you want it to be evenly spaced. So I'm gonna use my guides again to line this up. That looks pretty good. And this bottom one doesn't look very lined up, but it is, it's lined up. Okay. So if I duplicate this one more time, kind of get an idea where it would be, that's helpful, right? And then one more would be up there. And of course, they're all different images, your best images that you have, right? So as you can see, these need to be lined up better. So my top one needs to go over more over here. Then this one needs to go over. Then I turn on my bottom color, got my watermark, and I go file, save as. Save the whole thing as a Photoshop file while you're working on it. Put your name, final, save it as a Photoshop file, and also save it as a JPEG. And turn in that JPEG, say save, and then say okay. And that's what it'll look like. And I can actually view this if I go to view without the guides. So there's this clear guides. That's what it looks like. All right. Thanks, guys.